Okay. Good afternoon, everyone. And thank you very much, Vittorio, and thank you very much for giving me a chance to talk to you. My name is Tetsu Natsume, and I'm from Sony Computer Science Laboratory in Tokyo. But I'm not the researcher or scientist. Actually, I'm the salesman or laboratory. So, and my task is selling the CSL idea and the research into Sony and sometimes outside Sony as well. So, my main mission is technology transfer. So the reason is actually, as Vittorio mentioned, that the researcher is very free and thinking about the new crazy idea. And so that's why I don't want to bother them to doing the some kind of technology transfer job. And technology transfer is solely my responsibility, and I keep on bringing the idea into the Sony division, like a business division, like a TV or audio, and asking them to whether they want to utilize it. And if they accept it, I transfer the technology to them. But basically, I don't listen to them what they want, right? I just sending them what I have. So, but I don't want to listen what they want us to do. So that is the important point. So, by the way, for the first one is Xperia. So Xperia is the Sony's mobile phone. So actually within Xperia, there is five different technology coming from CSL. So for example, maybe I want to explain about the one technology called Feel, or maybe OneTouch. So this is the easy connection technology. So for example, if you are music inside the mobile phone and you want to touch, if you want to connect to the Wi-Fi speaker, so what you need to do is that you touch to the Wi-Fi speaker by mobile phone, and using the near field communication to exchange the IP address and the security key and establish the connection. Then after that, copy this connection to Wi-Fi. So even you release it, Wi-Fi is already connected, or maybe it can be Bluetooth. So this technology was invented in CSL in 2000, but actually becoming the actual product in 2012. So which means that it takes 12 years to becoming the actual product. So, and the reason why it takes 12 years is of course, after we invent the technology, immediately for myself, I start to introduce the technology to Sony people, business people, but nobody interested. So I go to the TV or audio or PlayStation or everyone, but not interested. Because if you remind about the 2000, maybe we don't have a smartphone and we don't have Wi-Fi speakers or maybe Wi-Fi cameras. So there's no necessity of the easy connections. So that's why they don't interest it. But after 10 years time, the smartphone was invented and the wireless speaker or Bluetooth speakers or Wi-Fi cameras, everything becoming the wireless. And we have a variety of wireless product in the room. So that's why the people start to think about how to connect. Then they remember, CSL have a good technology. So we transfer. So this is the one of the example. At this moment, almost all the Sony product using these technologies. But it takes like 15 years to becoming like this. So another thing, this is the activity classifier. So using the vibration to recognize whether you are walking or running or turning light or red or sitting. So this technology was invented in 2002, but actually it becomes the actual product in 2015. And you can see the guy over here. So he's the Brian Clarkson, so original researcher. And he carried the backpack over here. So this backpack is the sensor 15 years ago. So with the PC and the batteries and accelerometer, everything over inside this backpack. And he carries this for 100 days to collect all the data and write the papers. So this is a legend of the research. But actually, I introduced this technology immediately to business people. Nobody interested. But reason is very clear, too big. Too big to put into the, for example, maybe phone or maybe cameras or anything. But after 15 years, it becomes like the smart band. So of course, this smart band is consists of the smaller but efficient batteries and accelerometers and all the transmission technologies. But anyway, we have to wait that like 15 years. So my mission is the anyway. I start to introduce the technologies, but I have to wait until the people really require our technologies. Then another thing is machine learning. So machine learning is one of the hot topics, but we started this machine learning in 2005, and especially it was coming from the CSL Paris. And this technology called ELF. And then maybe I will skip on the details. But actually, this technology was used in the also smartphone to recognize the gestures. For example, if you want to answer the call, what you need to do is that you just put over here. So mobile phone will recognize whether you have this gesture or this gesture. So if you put this gesture, means that you want to answer the call. So this function is required by Russian people, because the Russian people normally wearing the glove, and they have the problem of unlocking the mobile phone. So that's why they want to answer by only gestures. So we put some sample of the vibration to the technology. Then technology will the machine learning software will automatically create the algorithm to separate. I should touch on the semiconductor issues, which Hiroaki already mentions. So we started the data analytics in the 90s. But in 2005, we started the project called the Stealth Project. So this Stealth Project is the targeting of the image sensors. So you have seen the very great image sensors. So not only for the spec itself, but also very strong in the manufacturing. So the reason is because we are in the behind of this manufacturing to doing all the data analytics. So by improving the data analysis, the yield ratio, this project can generate like maybe yearly more than $10 million, and maybe accumulatively we already saved for the more than $100 million US dollars. So and this is one of the reasons that the Sony headquarters is giving us the freedom of doing the researches. So this is the another example. But anyway, the secret of this project is that this project was originally done by one of the researcher in CSL, and he's the data analysis researchers, but we don't force him to do it. But actually, he voluntary, or maybe he eager to do this project, because once he joined to the Sony laboratories, and then he can do this kind of the collaborations. So normally, for example, data analysis of the semiconductor factory is very difficult because this kind of the data is very protected. So, but once he joined to the Sony and he can do, he can test it many technologies and method, then by this way that he can improve the ratio. So that's why actually this is the one of the his dreams to the becoming the this kind of the situations. Then finally, sorry for a bit of the promotion, but today, just I have 20 minutes, so I explain a little bit of the some example. But recently, I published a book called Out of the Lab on the Market, and it is already sold in the Amazon in English. So if you are interested, please buy this book from Amazon. Right? Thank you.